on certain aspects, sir. No doubt that the Consumer Protection Act, which was there earlier, is useful. We have to definitely take care of the consumers to make sure that they are not cheated of whatever their rights are. But here we are talking about a bill where we have made some fundamental changes in the already existing act. What is the need for those changes? If you go through the bill, we find that the need was only because of the time taken for the dispute to be addressed. There are instances where some cases have gone on for a very long time, sir. So to address this, if you are going to address only about the duration taken for a consumer to get justice, that is acceptable, sir. But here, we have made some fundamental changes in the composition of the commission at the district level, state level and national level. The changes are, earlier, the national level commission was to be appointed by the Supreme Court of India, the Chief Justice of the country, and the state level was by the High Court Justice, and the district court could have been by a person who is of not judiciary nature. But here in this bill, you have, like every other bill that this government has brought, you have made sure that these are people who are going to be nominated or appointed by the central government, and nobody has a right to question about the validity or their educational qualifications, because you have not specified what are the qualifications for these commissioners to be appointed. Sir, this is a very, very sad state of affairs, because you are taking the right out of the judicial system and taking it again into the central government. You have already taken so many powers from so many bodies. Do you want to take it away from the consumer also? Should the consumer also suffer because of this government, not federal, but the feudal attitude of this government? This government has made sure that there is no opposition. Like Shashi Tharoorji on the other day, he said, even some amendments which are of a good nature, you are not treating the
opposition. न करें इस सदन में, और हमारी हमेशा कोशिश होनी चाहिए. आपको कोई बात कहनी है, आपका सदन है, लोकतंत्र है, सबको इसमें कहने का अधिकार है, इसलिए आप चुनकर आए. लेकिन कोई भी ऐसा शब्द जिससे हमारी संसद की मर्यादा मीडिया में अन्य माध्यम से छवि खराब हो, ऐसा हमें कभी भी कोई कृत्य करने का प्रयास नहीं करना चाहिए. हमारी कोशिश ये होनी चाहिए कि हम किस तरीके से हम सदन की, इस सभापति पीठ की, अध्यक्षी पीठ की प्रतिष्ठा को बना सकें. मेरा दायित्व बनता है कि मैं सभी माननीय सदस्यों का संरक्षण करूं.
माननीय अध्यक्ष जी, जो बात आपके समक्ष मेरे संबंध में आई है, मेरी कोई ऐसी भावना चेयर के प्रति न थी, न हो सकती है. मैं दो बार संसदीय कार्य मंत्री रहा हूँ, चार बार मंत्री रहा हूँ, नौ बार विधायक रहा हूँ, राज्यसभा सदस्य रहा हूँ. मेरे भाषण, मेरे आचरण को पूरा सदन जानता है. इसके बावजूद भी अगर चेयर को मेरे प्रति ऐसा लगता है कि मुझसे कोई भावना में गलती हुई है, तो मैं उसकी क्षमा चाहता हूँ.
एक मिनट प्लीज. खड़े मत. आप रमा देवी जी, आप
मैं बगल में बैठा हूं, जो उनको कहना था उन्होंने अपनी किसी
आप एक बार आजम खान जी, आजम खान जी बोल दें. आप आजम खान जी, आप बोल दें. एक मिनट. हाँ, संसदीय कार्य मंत्री.
जो कुछ भी हुआ है, जो चर्चा हुआ है, हम सब बाद में भी जो चर्चा हुआ हम सब सुने हुए हैं. मैं सिर्फ ये अपील करता हूँ, जो महिला, पूरा महिला सदस्यों का और पूरा महिला समाज का अपमान हुआ है, ठीक ढंग, ठीक शब्द से
दैट इवन आवर प्रधानमंत्री इज हैविंग आईज ओनली फॉर अ सेलिब्रिटी सर. ही डज नॉट सी द कॉमन मैन. व्हेन अ विलेज, व्हेन अ एग्रीकल्चरिस्ट फ्रॉम तमिलनाडु कम्स एंड स्ट्राइक फॉर 100 डेज, दे इज वांटिंग टू रेज हिज कंसर्न्स, ही इज नॉट इंटरेस्टेड इन मीटिंग देम एट ऑल. But at the same time, a celebrity comes, within half an hour they get an appointment and they get to see him and talk about whatever they want to talk. He is more of a person who looks at media attention rather than the health of the people and the concerns of the people, sir. Sir, the other thing which I want to point out in this bill, you are talking about consumer protection. For any consumer protection, I think there is something called as an ombudsman, sir. An ombudsman is a person who is appointed by a particular company, the respective companies, where you can raise grievances before coming to these commissions. You can talk to the company, find out what is wrong, and then you can address these issues. But most of the time, people are not aware of who the ombudsman is, how he can be contacted, and even if they have an ombudsman, it is through an email, and when you send a mail, there is no response to it. Or there is a very dubious reply where you will have no answer to your issues. So we are left with no choice but to go to a consumer court. But again, like my friend over here said, when you go to the consumer court, how many people are aware? I think most of the people over here, they themselves will not be aware. We are all educated members of parliament. We will not be aware of about how to address the grievance, how to go about getting a solution for our problem. So when this is the case, how do you expect a common man, an illiterate, to get justice when he is being cheated? The same way we are talking about MRPs, sir. MRPs, we say that these products should not be sold above that price. We are talking about instances where they are sold for probably 10 rupees above the price, or even in some buses where we are going by government buses or private buses, people claim that we don't have change. And if you look at the volumes, when thousands and lakhs of people are traveling, this amounts to a huge amount, sir. So these kind of issues, for a 2 rupee, I will not want to take the pain and go and complain to somebody. There should be some kind of an email through which he can address the issue, and action should be taken. See, sending an email alone is not enough, sir. If we send an email, there should be a proper response and action should be taken, and the person who has complained should be given a detailed reply about what action has been taken. And we're talking about unfair contract and restrictive trade practices. Sir, restrictive trade practices, we are talking about companies which are giving false promises and selling a product. We have to be happy that political parties do not fall in this ambit, sir. Because this 2014, the false promises made by this government of saying that we will pay 15 lakh into every person's account and get 10 crore jobs for the people over here, and we'll bring back money from all over the world and bring it back into our country and make our country one of the richest nations, has not materialized, sir. It is funny to note that the government which came to power with such false promises is taking action against companies which are not keeping their promises. Isn't it funny to see something like that happening, sir? And the other thing is medical profession. Sir, I want to talk about this because medical profession, we are all suffering because we know the number of crimes which are being committed against doctors, sir. And also, not only the crimes, frivolous cases are being filed against medical professionals because some lawyer instigates them saying, even if there is no case, I will run this case, and if we win, I'll take 70% of whatever is offered, and the remaining 30% or 10% goes to the patient, sir. Here, I would suggest that you try to bring a policy where any medical cases, first it should be sent to the concerned state medical commissions, and only if they say that there is some validity in having a case over here, these cases should be filed. Because umpteen number of cases are filed against doctors, they have to be given some respite because they cannot practice in peace if this policy is continued, sir. Sir, sir, I would also like to say the insurance companies, especially in hospitals, being a doctor, I have seen, like, even I may have a claim for 5 lakhs also, sir. I may be eligible for 5 lakhs, but the insurance company says only 30,000 will be paid to you, and the remaining amount, whatever the hospital charges, you have to pay it on your own. These are all some issues which we are not able to raise at all. Patients are not able to raise in the public forum, sir. I hope that the government will be able to do something about this. Thank you very much, sir.